guys. Today is going to be a Easter nail tutorial. As you can see, I've already done my right hand. I find it's a bit different to the normal Easter nails with the pastel colours and everything, but I wanted to do something a bit different. As you can see, my nails are neon pink gel base, and I've already put the magpie glitters on already. The magpie glitters that I've used are Lily and Cindy, and I'll be using my Creative Shop stamper and scraper. I'll also be using the Dashika stamping polishes, and the plate I'll be using is from Moyou London from the Festive collection, and it's number 9. Okay, so here are the glitters. The first one is Lily, and this one I have on my ring finger. Hey, it's been so long, I forgot how to turn it up, 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 up all night long. Oh, up, up all night long. This is my heartbeat song, and I'm gonna play it, turn it. And this one is Cindy, and it's like a it's a neon pink colour. And obviously, as I've just said, I've got neon gel polish on underneath, and I've put this Cindy one on the rest of them. Okay, so here's the stamping plate. I'll be doing my thumb first, and I'll be doing that Happy Easter sign. I'll be doing that in black, and then I'll be doing the bunny ears in white. I'll be showing you how to paint in the stamping, if that makes sense. The next one I'll be doing is this butterfly here, and I'll show you in a second what I mean by painting in the stamper. Right, okay, now you've got, I've stamped on the butterfly, and any excess that you have, you can use your scraper to just pat down lightly and get rid of any unwanted images that you have. Now I have the butterfly on here, and I'm waiting about 2 minutes for it to just settle down, and then what I'll be doing is I'll be using this neon stamping polish and the yellow stamping polish, both from Dashika, I think I said that right. I'll be using them. What you want to do is you want to paint on the colours thinly. You don't want to paint them on too thick. If you paint them on too thick, then they won't dry properly and they'll smudge. So if you paint them on quite thin, then they should come out perfect. Once you've done that, leave it for about 2 to 3 minutes. And then after 2 to 3 minutes, then you can stamp straight onto your nail with it. Right, forgive the dodgy angle on my nail that I've just stamped on. It's because I'm at an awkward angle when I was filming this. But I hope that you can get the sort of gist of what I mean by painting in the stamper. Next, I'll be doing the basket. The basket's quite hard to do, so forgive me if it looks a bit messy. When I stamp it, as I said, it is this one is, for me, I found it harder to do than the others. Open doors for me and you might get some kisses. Don't have a dirty mind, just be a classy guy. Buy me a ring, buy me a ring. For painting in this pattern, I'll be using a nail art pen paintbrush instead of the actual brushes that the polishes come in, just because that the nail art paintbrush is better because it's thinner. Once again, once you've painted it, leave for 2 to 3 minutes and then you can stamp. Solid gold, I love you, you'll never know. When the daylight comes, you feel so cold. You know, I'm too afraid of my heart to let you go. Waiting for the fire to light, feeling like we could do right. Be the one that makes tonight. Freedom is a lonely road. We're under control. Okay, now these are all stamped. I'm going to top coat these and then wipe the tacky layer off once I've top coated them. Right, so here are they finished. As I said before, sorry about the awkward angle. It's just because I'm at an awkward angle when I filmed this. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe, comment, or like below. I will be posting a video once a week, either on a Sunday, either on a Saturday or a Sunday. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Bye. In the sun, your heartbeat of solid gold. I love you. You'll never know when the daylight comes. You